Delivery Hero. I know the company, some of my friends are working there, but I'd like to hear from you.
So, Delivery Hero, if I'll say, it's a food aggregator company. So, not only in single country, but we are live in 42 countries with 26 plus brands.
Okay.
So, it's like basically in Southeast Asia, we are live with the name of Food Panda, Foodora. But in Middle East Asia, we are live with the name of Talaba. So like this, we have 26 brands in more than 42 countries. Like we just launched in Europe, in Germany with the name of Foodpanda.
Okay.
So this is what Delivery Hero does. Moreover, basically, it's not only for basically customers, but for the vendors also. We tell the vendors how their performance is doing and all of those things. They can change their opening hours, they can change their menus online, on our apps, on our websites. So okay, we offer both the support to them.
Does it also has another app? So they have a separate app or they use the web?
Yes. So we have, so customers, consumer facing app is one. Then we have one app for the kitchen where they accept orders. Then we have third app and website basically for the vendors, for the restaurant owners.
Okay.
So they can access, they can see the performance and everything from anywhere they are. So
okay,
because think of a restaurant owner, they are having a chain of restaurants. So they don't necessarily need to be in the kitchen or basically in the restaurant to see how exactly their restaurant is performing. They can have a look at while they're sitting, they are relaxing at their home in the night or in the morning. They can check how, what all orders they had, what is the revenue they are getting out of this. So it's altogether a different app for them. For
okay, nice, nice. I can see this display here and people gathering and trying to solve the question, what's going on?
So it's just, I would say, fun Kotlin challenge. So we basically came up with, so one of our teammates who is sitting over there in that community group booth, he came up with all the fun questions. Basically, it's a tricky questions.
Okay.
So about Kotlin, as it's an Android, DroidCon basically, for the Android community. So we just came up with some fun questions. Okay, let's see
okay
whether they will be able to catch the trick. What's the catch in these questions?
Okay, cool. So it's kind of like a puzzle.
Yes.
Okay, okay. And what are you doing in DroidCon? Why here?
So I'm very active in Android community. So
yeah,
I've been there in many conferences, be it meetup for the Kotlin or be it meetup for the Android or be it DroidCon. So I've attended many DroidCon. So you'll get to know, hear about various people, various speakers, what exactly they are doing. So one of the talks which I'll talk about, the Nelson, which I gave a talk about the cache effects, that was pretty interesting, I would say. Because if you are working in Android, at some point of time, you have to basically solve these issues for the cache, Gradle and all of it. Because this is a pain in the ass, I must say,
for every
Android developer.
Okay.
So
yeah,
over here, coming over here, interacting with the community, it's really good. Plus, moreover, we are looking for Android developers. If you are interested, please go to our career website and join our company. So,
nice.
Our company offers the work culture, I must tell you, it's one of the best in Berlin or in Germany or in Europe.
Okay, nice. Talking about Kotlin, is the app 100% Kotlin or not yet?
100% Kotlin.
Nice.
100% Kotlin.
Cool. Nice to meet you.
Same here.
Bye.
Thank you. Bye.